swim! Nice swim!
With the Knights entering the championship series with a 12-game win streak, the pressure was on.
What you work for. The haze in the barn. There's no more, let's work on this, let's work on that. It's over.
Hey, they got to get their coach to hype them up. They don't want it. They don't want it. We want it. Let's go.
We were talking about this day back then. Now we're here. So what are you going to do about it? We're going to win.
Throwing out the first pitch was a complete surprise for me. I had no clue that it was happening. I was actually in the dugout just talking to Judd, and then all of a sudden I hear Coach Suarez needs my name, and you know, first thing I think of is, oh, I'm in trouble, you know, I did something stupid. But you know, he just makes me like wait next to him, and by the time the first pitch, everyone wants to see the first pitch, you know, I get my name called and I'm throwing out the first pitch, which was super, super cool because you know, it was just nice to be a part of the state championship kind of thing. And, you know, walking out there, it was really cool. It was a little embarrassing just because, you know, I don't know. I don't like being in the spotlight too much. But it was really, really cool to be able to throw out the first pitch, especially because Suarez in front of, you know, all the fans of the state championship.
Well, Philip throwing the first pitch was something that we talked about and I kind of had to brainstorm about, ran it by some guys, and they thought it was a good idea. Gosh, his leadership in the dugout, he was here all the time. He was chirpy in the dugout to get the guys going. And he was always in the game. I mean, as a matter of fact, I used to have to tell him, hey, you need to settle down. Because he was just as much in the game as if he was playing. And I think that says a lot for his character.
We are ready to go. It is Charlotte Christian versus Wesleyan Christian for the title.
For that first inning, I got run into some trouble. I gave up a home run first inning.
Drew Downs takes the first pitch for a home run, and the Trojans draw first blood.
But like from that point on, I just knew like I just had to settle down, just relax, and just do my job.
I think the turning point to the whole series was game one, when we had two high D1 pitchers going against each other, and our guys began to really compete at a high level. You know, Calvert go out and throw a good inning, we'd score a run, and then we'd come back and throw a zero on the board. I knew when that happened that we were moving in the right direction.
Calvert Clark launches a solo shot for the Knights.
For us to win that first game and just to set it up, it was huge because you get that first game out of the way and it takes a little bit of pressure off because you know you got two games to play with essentially. So
as the Knights look to finish Wesleyan Christian off in game two, Everett Harris was on the mound.
Yeah, so pregame, I went through my regular routine, just kind of running, going through all my stretches and stuff, and I felt really good.
I don't know what's gonna bring you down. I don't know what's gonna bring you down. I don't know, but I'm gonna bring you down.
I gave gave up a three-run bomb to Jacob Cozart, one of my good buddies.
Jacob Cozart hits an absolute bomb to right center. It is a 3-1 home run for Wesleyan Christian.
My role on this team was to be a leader, so when we went down 4-0, I went up to Everett on the mound and told him to just relax, keep us in the game. I told him that I had the most confidence in him that I have of anybody on this team. The first inning, I gave up 5 runs. I lost focus, I was missing a lot of spots. I was falling behind in counts and kind of serving the ball up there, hanging some curveballs.
Wesleyan Christian bats around in the first inning, and the result is 5 runs cross the plate for the Trojans.
I'm only human after all. I'm only human after all. Don't put the blame on me.
And then after that inning, I sat down with Coach Simmons, and we had a little heart to heart, and he basically said, like, we need you to go this whole game. I need you to get it together.
My conversation with Everett after the first inning, this kid's a really talented kid. I've known him forever. I wish it was something really nice and poetic and spiritual, but it wasn't. I pretty much came out and said, if you want to suck for the next 7 innings, you're pitching 120 pitches. So you can either do that now or stretch it out. And he pretty much looked at me and said, I got it. And my goodness, after the first inning, he was lights out.
Some people got the real problems. Some people out of love. Some people think I can solve them. Lord, heaven's above. I'm only human after all. I'm only human after all. Don't put the blame on me. Don't put the blame on me.
His ability to finish that game was paramount in the third game because we didn't use any pitching. We saved all our guys. I thought that was really important.
Didn't give up a hit the rest of the time and shut him out. We ended up losing 5-1, but I thought that was a great spot to put us in to have Wesley game 3 because obviously they were a little short on the mound.
It definitely was kind of demoralizing, not having good ABs, not having good at-bats in game 2.
I wanted to go out there and pitch, especially since I haven't pitched all season. You know, it was hard for me to deal with all that. I was overcome with emotions after the game, losing. You know, I didn't want to lose the state championship. It's the only one that I've been in.
In game 2, we kind of got punched in the mouth a little bit, but our guys never lost focus. We brought all the guys together in about the 4th inning of game 2. And we told them, said, look, it looks like we're going to lose this game. We need to start preparing to win game 3.
After all, I'm only human. After all, don't put the blame on me.
We tell our players there's only one thing that we can promise them, and that's adversity. But there was a time where I started saying, okay, God, we got plenty of this. It's time to move to another one. And our guys did a real good job of kind of embracing the adversity, and I think that prepared us for game 3, because had we not faced some adversity, when your back's against the wall, that's a pretty adverse situation, especially for a bunch of 17, 18-year-old guys.
Don't put your blame on me.
After a devastating loss, the Knights had no choice but to regather and fight back.
So after we dropped game 2, I'm not going to lie, it was a little nerve-wracking, but at the same time, we knew that they were a good team, but we also knew that we were a better team. So it was almost like a mindset of, well, they took the one game that they had a chance of winning.
So game 3, we really need to step it up.
Going into game 3, I knew I had to step up. It's the biggest game of my life. So I knew I couldn't let the nerves get to me, but I had to go into that game knowing that I was going to be the best pitcher out there. No one was going to beat me. Batters weren't going to beat me. Nothing.
Well, Wesley is kind of a unique kid. He comes here. He doesn't know our program. He's a JV player. He goes from pitching on the JV in game one to pitching in the state championship game three. But in all honesty, I wasn't nervous at all. The kid is really good, really talented. And I knew that if he had the ball in game three, he would be fine. And to be honest, the only nerves I had was in the first inning, because I knew if he could pitch well in the first inning, he'd be okay.
Three up, three down, nobody left. And this time it is the Charlotte Christian Knights that strike first.
Pitcher was throwing me a lot of curveballs, so I was expecting slider or curveball, and he hung over to the plate, and the rest is history. But that, there's no better feeling than ending my career like that.
Will Ferrell absolutely smokes one over the wall for the Knights. A solo home run.
Six innings, shutout, no runs. So that was very good. I mean, but that's not all me. I had the greatest defense behind me that a pitcher could ask for. I mean, I had guys making plays for me left and right. Whenever I didn't step up, they would, and it was just so nice knowing they had my back. And
then I looked up at the scoreboard in the sixth inning and I said, my goodness, we've outscored them every inning and scored every inning. That's when I kind of started taking stuff out of my back pocket, knowing that I was going to run out and jump on the pile, because I thought we were okay then.
So it was 3-2 on that last pitch, bases loaded.
Come on.
Call it!
Judd catching it, it was just... surreal. It was great. That the love has died.
I feel like there was just a ton of energy in that one moment, and it's something I remember the rest of my life. All the love
has died. When Judd caught that ball, I just thought of the impact Charlotte Christian baseball has had on my career.
Coach Simmons and I, we had a moment after the game where we hugged and we just had a small little talk. And he was just saying he was grateful I came here. And I couldn't be more grateful for this program and for Coach Simmons.
It's probably one of the most satisfactory feelings in the world, probably, just to say, like, hey, like, state champion, you know, two-time state champion.
It was definitely emotional seeing everyone's, you know, crying, you know, tears, joy mostly.
It was just, it's pretty cool to just have that moment with those guys and just to hug it out with them and just be like, hey, yeah, like, we're one more away from accomplishing the goal that we set, so.
Charlotte Christian wins their 16th state championship.
You know, the way I'd rather go out, I love all these people that have impacted me these last 4 years, and I'll never forget it. I'll truly never forget it.
My mom and dad were very supportive, and one of the things that my mom asked me every spring, every time I called her, first thing she would say is, I don't call her enough. And then she would ask me how the season was going, and she would always ask me, did we win? And after that state championship, I got a little emotional, because the first thing that she would have asked me is, did we win? And we did.